Now we are moving on to the next area, that is assessment and audit under customs. See, this is the last topic under customs. Assessment, we have two types of assessment, that is self-assessment and provisional assessment. When the importer or exporter can assess how much customs duty they can pay, that is known as self-assessment. And whenever they make a self-assessment, that is bill of entry or shipping bill, then some bill of entries and shipping bills will be selected for verification by the proper officer and some risk parameter basis. If it is final, then assessment is completed. Otherwise, they will do reassessment. Suppose if there are some comparable imports which are at a higher value, but what they declared as a lower value in case of import, so the reassessment will be done by the customs officer after verification. And if the importer agrees to pay that reassessed duty, he can pay that reassessed duty and the goods will be cleared. If the importer is contesting about that reassessed duty, then he can request for a speaking order. They will pass a speaking order within 15 days and you can go for an appeal against that speaking order. That is this speaking order within 15 days from the date of reassessment of the bill of entry or shipping bill, as the case may be passed. And on that you can go for appeal, okay. Then we have something called as provisional assessment under section 18 of the Customs Act. Under provisional assessment, generally provisional assessment under GST is done whenever that person is unable to compute the GST payable because the value is not known or the rate is not known. But in case of customs, the provisional assessment is not only because of the reason that importer or exporter cannot compute the customs duty payable, but also on account of, you know, other reasons. What are those other reasons? Say, those goods which are imported by the importer and exporter are, those goods which are imported by the importer are subject to chemical examination or test. In that case, the proper officer will pass a provisional assessment order. Or some documents needs to be furnished, but the documents are not furnished, then also provisional assessment order. Some documents needs to be furnished and furnished but not sufficient, those documents are not sufficient, then also provisional assessment order will be passed. So these are the four reasons or situations why there will be provisional assessment under customs. So it can be asked as a short note question, and in this regard they have given that customs finalization of provisional assessment regulations 2018. What is that? First, an opportunity should be given to produce the documents, and if the documents are not produced within 15 days or such further extended time of, you know, 3 months or 3 months by ACDC or unlimited time by the commissioner, in that case a provisional assessment order will be passed. And once the provisional assessment order is passed, if the documents are submitted, then within 2 months from the date of receipt of documents, they will finalize the provisional assessment. If the documents are not submitted, within 2 months after expiry of the time allowed, they will complete the provisional assessment. And thereafter, plus 3 months extension may be granted. Okay. So this is the time limit. Now, when final assessment is greater than the provisional assessment, we need to pay the differential duty along with interest at the rate of 15% per annum from the first day of the month in which we resorted to provisional assessment. So, provisional assessment order is passed on 28th March means from 1st March we need to compute the interest. Unnecessarily for those days also we need to calculate, okay, till the date of payment of differential amount. Suppose if both are same, final assessment equals to provisional assessment, then nothing is payable, nothing we will get as a refund. Suppose when final assessment is less than the provisional assessment, then whatever excess we have paid, so that will be given to us as a refund within 3 months from the date of finalization of assessment. If the refund is not given within 3 months from the date of finalization of assessment, then we will get a interest at the rate of 6% per annum is payable for the delay period beyond 3 months. Beyond 3 months, they will pay interest at the rate of 6% per annum. And for the purpose of provisional assessment, importer shall execute a bond, and if it is warehousing, twice the amount of duty payable. And refund of duty upon final assessment subject to unjust enrichment means you should not have passed on the burden to the next person. If you pass on the burden to the next person, they will not give refund in this case, whatever excess amount that we have paid. Okay. Then provisional assessment is applicable for both imports and exports, and contravention of any provisions of these regulations. Remember, under customs, the penalty is always up to 50,000 rupees. Contravention of any provision, the penalty is up to 50,000. Then we have audit under section 99A. Audit under customs, is post clearance audit. At the time of clearance, they will not do the audit. Post clearance, either customs officer will go to the premises or they will ask importer or exporter to bring the documents to the premises, okay, to the customs officer's place. So either way can happen, and that is known as post clearance audit. So post clearance audit will be done by the proper officer either at the premises of the auditee or in the premises of the customs officer. Now there are certain regulations in this regard. Customs audit regulations 2018, in that regulation 3 says that the books of accounts under customs should be preserved for a period of 5 years, whereas under GST the books of accounts should be preserved for a period of 72 months, that is 6 years, whereas here it is 5 years, and there 6 years from the due date of furnishing annual return, here it is 5 years. And regulation 4, so they will be selecting the auditee or documents based on some risk parameter basis. There are two types of audit under customs: transaction based audit and premises based audit. Transaction based audit means first they will check few transactions, and if they have any doubt related to those transactions that these are not proper, then that will be converted into premises based audit. So entire premises of the importer or exporter, all the records during a particular period will be audited by the customs department. Then regulation 5, audit can be conducted at the auditee premises, but a 15 days notice will be given, whereas under GST, that is 15 working days notice by department audit. In case of department, when they are conducting the audit, they will give a 15 working days notice, but here it is 15 days notice. And regulation 6, CRCMA can assist for the customs officer to do the audit, but they cannot do the audit. Customs audit cannot be done by CRCMA, they can only assist. And contravention of any provisions of this audit will lead to a penalty of up to 50,000 rupees. So these are the provisions related to that. And then already we discussed about delay in payment. Deferred payment option is applicable in case of importer. In case of importer, there are two payment options. Option number one, immediate payment option. So they need to pay immediately as and when the bill of entry is returned for payment. Otherwise, they will pay interest at the rate of 15% per annum for every day delay. Whereas in case of deferred payment option, if the bill of entry is returned between 1st to 15th day of a particular month, the due date of payment of customs duty is by 16th working day of that month. Between 1st to 15th, 16th working day. If the bill is returned for payment between 16th to end of that month, then next month first working day you should take. If it is March month, 31st March, that is the due date. If you are not making payment by the due date, then interest will be payable at the rate of 15% per annum for every day delay. Okay. Then for which type of importers it is applicable? Deferred payment option is applicable for those importers who are covered under authorized economic operator program. So under authorized economic operator program, there are certain importers, there are certain people who are recognized by Government of India as authorized economic operators. So those people are only eligible for deferred payment option. Then duty payable on account of reassessment or provisional assessment. Say reassessment will be done by the proper officer whenever we file a self-assessment return, and whenever they do reassessment, so whenever they pass a reassessment order, within one working day we should pay. Otherwise interest is payable at the rate of 15% per annum for delay. And if it is provisional assessment also, that provisional assessment amount is there, na? that provisional assessment amount you have to pay within one working day, otherwise interest is payable on provisional duty. Now final assessment already we discussed, whenever the final assessment happens, at that time you need to pay differential duty along with interest from the first day during which the final, like provisional assessment is, order is passed, from the first day of the month in which provisional assessment order is passed till the date of payment of the differential amount. So this is related to the interest provisions I have just given. So with this, assessment and audit under customs is over, and entire customs portion we have completed.